What's going on, Will students? Thank you so much for tuning in tonight, wherever you are, however you're watching this. Thank you for being here. With the uncertainties of the weather tonight, the leaders and I decided it would be best to just do this online. We'll be together next week, so don't cry too much. Don't be too sad. I know it's disappointing, but trust me, next week we'll be back together for our Super Bowl party. It's gonna be awesome. Yeah, I have a little challenge for you, all right? Since this is all online, we want to do something a little bit fun. We want to switch it up a little bit. So here's what I need from you. This video is on YouTube and Instagram, but for my Instagram peeps, those of you watching on Instagram, if I see 15 people share this on their story, tag the Well 614, and then tag two friends in the comments, tonight about 6 or 7 p.m., I'm going to do a lap around my apartment complex barefoot in the snow just to make you guys laugh and I'll feel some pain. So share this video, get it out there, spread the word, encourage people with what we're about to talk about here. And then also, the person who tags the most friends in the comments, I don't know if you know this, but next week at our Super Bowl party, there's some beanies coming out. They look like this. This color at least, but they have the Well really big across the front in white. The person who tags the most friends in the comment section on Instagram is gonna get one of those for free. That's all you have to do, okay? So that's my challenge for you. Let's dive into this message.
Now to Australia, where they're facing those massive fires.
You have a million different faces.
Breaking news in this Sunday afternoon, former league MVP Kobe Bryant died in a helicopter crash.
Now to growing concerns about the deadly coronavirus.
Overnight, nationwide unrest. Large crowds of demonstrators in multiple cities getting more violent.
Lost in
So the last couple weeks we've been in this series called When Our Faith Feels Frozen, right? And when we've been talking about how to break this cycle of faith that we sometimes get stuck in. Sometimes it feels like our faith is so boring and so frozen and so lame and so routine. And how do we break that? Because the truth of the matter is we've all felt that and been stuck in that cycle at some point in time. So what do we do? How do we get out of it? Week number one, we talked about how you need to let it go. You need to let go of your parents' faith. You need to let go of your friends' faith. You need to let go of your church's faith. You need to step into your own personal relationship with Jesus. That is step number one to breaking this frozen, mundane cycle of faith. Week number two, we looked at the song called When I'm Older, which Mr. Olaf sings for us, right? And we talked about this idea and this lie that sometimes we get wrapped up in, that we need to be older, we need to be accomplished, we need to be developed before God can use us. We talked about how this is a lie, how the devil wants us to believe this. Yeah, he celebrates every time we wait, every time we hesitate to be used by God. The devil is like, score, victory, that's a dub for me. And so he really loves that. And so that's what we talked about week number two. And then last week, we dove into this idea that love is an open door. And of course, we were talking about Jesus's love. We were talking about how God loves us so much. We say these things like God's love is unconditional and it'll never change and it'll never go away. And if that's true, then God's love is not based on you. It's not based on me. It's not based on our actions. It's based on who he is. And there's never been a person created on this earth that was not created, designed, and loved by God. So for tonight, we're wrapping up this message, and this message is going to be huge. There's a lot of you watching this video right now who are going to really connect and really be impacted by this message, and hopefully they don't mind me sharing this, but a couple weeks ago, we took some students to Grove City on a Friday night, and we were riding home. Me and Lexi were driving, and there were some senior girls in the back seat. Sorry, shouting you guys out, I know. And they brought up this question of our calling. And they brought up this idea that they feel stressed and confused and not really sure how to interpret God's calling for their life. And it made me realize that this is a really, really big topic of discussion. I'm realizing that maybe now more than ever, you guys watching this video, your generation, the people in your school, the people in your circles, they want to know about their calling. What does God have planned for them? What does he want for them? How is he going to use them? This is a topic that, you know, is just going to always be there. So let's address it. Let's dive headfirst into it. Let's figure out what the Bible has to say about our calling. And here's the deal. All right, the song that we're using, I know some of you are like, what song are we going to rip off this week from Frozen? The song we're using for tonight is Into the Unknown. Okay, does anybody know that song? It won like a Grammy, I think. It was a big deal from Frozen 2. But look, here's the idea of why this song was written. Elsa, right, she gets this calling. She hears this voice singing to her in Frozen 2, if you've ever seen it. It's kind of like the drive of the entire movie. She feels this voice and hears this voice singing to her, and she's just so worried about following it, and she's not sure what it means, what it's going to do to her, where it's going to lead her, what it's going to say, and she's just very, very confused by this thing. But as you know, if you've seen the movie, she follows it, she finds it, she gets led to this incredible thing, whatever. That's not the point. But into the unknown. Some of us are so scared of what's in the unknown. We don't want to trust God with what's in the unknown. We don't want to give him our future. We'd rather just hold on to it really tightly. So we're going to be talking about how we can let God lead us into the unknown. And this is going to tie perfectly into this conversation about our calling and about where God wants us to go. And my main idea is this. What I want you to get out of this message is this, and I hope you have your Bible. I hope you have a journal. Write this down. Here's the main fact. Chase God, not your calling. Chase God, not your future. Chase God, not anything else that can come your way. Look, we love to say this thing of like, what's God going to call me to? What's God going to lead me to? What does God have planned for my future? And that's all great, but that question means nothing if you aren't following God yourself, right? If God is going to be the one that has this calling for you and wants to give you this plan in your life, then how can you get this plan from God if you don't know God? How can you get this plan from God if you're not following God? So here's the main idea. Chase God, not your calling. If I can get you on this mindset, if I can get you to start to think that way, where you're pursuing God over your calling and over your future and over your career and over your school, then everything is going to change completely. And I'll say for me, I my entire time in high school, I was following God, but not first. I was so worried about my future. I was so worried about my calling. I didn't really know what I was going to do. And it wasn't until my senior year of high school that I started following God above everything else. And my calling became extremely clear. So we're going to be picking up in Luke chapter 22. If you have your Bibles, please follow along with us. But here's the deal. Luke chapter 22. This is right at the Last Supper. Jesus was predicting the fact that he was going to be betrayed, that Judas was actually going to give him up to the people who were going to arrest him. He was saying all of these things, and the disciples were very distraught and very confused. And they began to argue amongst themselves, trying to figure out who would do this to Jesus. In Luke 22:23, we're going to pick up the story, and it says this. The disciples began to ask each other, which of them would do such a thing? So they start to argue, they start to bicker, they start to try to figure this out. Verse 24, then they began to argue among themselves about who would be the greatest among them. So they're sitting at this table with Jesus, and he tells them, listen, guys, I'm going to be arrested. Okay, I'm probably going to be killed, and that's the deal. And they start to argue and go amongst themselves and say, who would do such a terrible thing? And it basically gets to the point where some of them are saying, well, not me, because I'm the best disciple. And the other one's like, nah, bro, I did this the other day. I'm the best disciple. And the other one's like, well, yeah, well, I retweeted Jesus's tweet. So I'm just kidding. But they all begin to bicker and argue over who is the greatest among them. And it's really funny because guess what they were doing? They were focused on their reputation and on their future and on their calling, and they completely missed out that Jesus was sitting right in front of them. They were pursuing their status and who they were and what they were going to accomplish over who Jesus was and what he wanted for them. And I feel like a lot of us are in that very boat. When we start to get into this idea of our future and our calling and all these different things, we get so wrapped up and so focused on these different career paths and different choices and what college to go to that we miss out on the reason why we get to do those things, which is God. And in verse 25, Jesus speaks to them as they're arguing, as they're bickering amongst whose calling is the greatest and who's the best around them. Jesus cuts in and he says this: "In the world, the kings and great men lord it over their people, yet they were called friends of the people." So what he says is, look, in the world we live in, the people of power, the people of big status, they hold that over everybody else. So in modern times, he's talking about government officials and people who have a lot of influence in our world. They hold that above everybody else in the world that we live in. He goes on and he says, "But among you, it will be different." And he's not just talking to the disciples sitting with him at this table. He's talking to you. He's talking to me. He's talking to everybody who is a Jesus follower. He says, "Those who are the greatest among you should take the lowest rank, and the leader should be like a servant." He says, "Who is more important, the one who sits at the table or the one who serves?" The one who sits at the table, of course. And so he kind of, I would imagine he pauses here, and the disciples are like, yeah, that's why we're arguing. It's the greatest one. It's the one who sits at the table. But he doesn't stop there. He goes on and he says this: "But not here. For I am among you as one who serves." Think about this. The Son of God came to this world and died for you and me, and he did so in a way that was so low, and he had such a low rank in society and in status, because he was setting up this example that you do not have to be great, you do not have to be well known, you do not have to be famous, you do not have to be an influencer to be used by God. So I want to go back to this question: are you pursuing God, or are you pursuing your calling? Are you giving God your future, or are you so consumed with your future that you're missing out on who God is? And Jesus says, look, those of you who are my followers, guess what? You need to make yourself the servants. You need to make yourself the lowest. And the disciples are mind blown by this. Some of us hearing this are mind blown by this. Now, this doesn't mean that Jesus wants to use, you know, Christ's followers only to be the lowest of the low in society, but what he wants us to do is have a servant heart all the time. What he wants us to do is, no matter where he leads us, no matter how he uses us, no matter how, you know, or where he puts us in life, we're going to be content with serving him above all else. And that's what I want to say. If you're serving God, guess what? You're never going to miss your calling. Never. You are never going to miss out on your calling. You are never going to, you know, be unsure or unpredicted or what's it going to be, if your main obsession and your main focus and your main desire is serving God above all else. If you can do that, if you can get yourself there, you will never miss your calling. You want to break your frozen faith? We've asked this question every week of this series. Right? We're talking about getting out of this cycle, about getting out of this dull routine. You want to break it? You want to get out of it? Pursue Jesus first. Serve Jesus first. Trust Jesus first. Love Jesus first. Allow him to become first in your life. Not your future, not your calling, not your job, not how much money you make, not your influence, not your status. Jesus. If he becomes first in your life, I promise you, you will never miss your calling. If you are giving him your heart, if you are following him every single day, you will not miss your calling. Now, does this mean that everything in life is just going to be easy? It's just going to be figured out? It's just going to be simple? I'm sorry, I don't think so. But if Jesus is your first place thing, if Jesus is the thing that your heart beats for, then even if life completely throws you off your rhythm, even if your future is nothing like you ever planned it to be, it doesn't matter, because your roots and your hope and your trust is in Jesus. So pursue Jesus first. Give God your everything first, and you'll never miss your calling. And the funny thing is, I've said this earlier, we talk about this calling from God. How can you get it from God if you don't know God? How can you get it from God if you're not following God? Pursue him first. Don't wait. Don't say, yeah, you know, God, I'll give you my time when I have this figured out. God, I'll give you my time when I, you know, my future makes a little bit more sense. Don't do that. Step into a relationship with him now. Pursue him now. Give him your heart now. Give him 10 minutes out of your day. Read your Bible, pray to him, journal, talk to him. Give him yourself first. And if you're pursuing him first, you will never miss your calling. Let God lead you into the unknown. You're not gonna know what it's gonna look like. It might not make sense. It might not be what you could ever predict. But if God is what's first in your life, and you're not worrying about who's the greatest, you're not worrying about what your calling is, you're not constantly trying to figure it out and make it work and strive to make it better, if you're just trusting God and you're letting him lead you into life, then trust me, you're going to be exactly where God wants you to be. Let's pray. Father, we just come before you today, and I know this is a little bit weird doing this over, you know, strictly video, but Lord, I pray that we are impacted by your word today. I pray that we can walk away from hearing this message a little bit more, you know, just understanding of who you are and what you want for us. Lord, I pray that we can understand how to follow you first, how to love you and trust you first. And if we do that, Lord, you are going to give us the desires of our heart. You are going to give us, you know, the best future and the best plan, better than anything we could ever imagine. So, Lord, I just pray that as students listen to this, whenever they listen to this, that they are impacted and they are molded and they are shaped by what you want to say to us today. We love you so much. We're so thankful for you. Amen. Real quick. Before you go, just a couple things coming up. Some of you are wondering about the creative night, all right? That is gonna be next week at 5 p.m. before the Super Bowl party. So if you're interested in that, if that's something you were thinking about coming to, it is gonna be next week right before the Super Bowl party. Also, the Super Bowl party is next week. So 6:30 to 8 p.m., we're gonna have a bunch of food. We're gonna be watching the game. We're gonna be playing cornhole and hanging out. It's gonna be awesome. Don't miss it. And this is a super easy event to bring your friends to. So make sure you invite somebody new. Also, camp. This week is the last week for the early bird deal. So make sure if you're interested in camp, start talking to your parents, get in their ear, annoy them. Make sure they know that that deadline is coming up this week. February 6th is the last day to get the early bird discount. Also, last thing, this is the last part of our series called When Our Faith Feels Frozen. But guess what? On February 14th, Valentine's Day, because it's perfect timing, we are kicking off a brand new series called It's the Blank for Me, all right? We're gonna be talking about singleness and dating and all that fun stuff. And I promise you, even if you're not in a relationship, this series is going to be so beneficial and so good. So I cannot wait for that. But we miss you guys. We hope that you stay safe and you stay warm, and we'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. We are wrapping up our series called When Our Frozen Feel. Stability and so we don't wanna, dang it. And then, and loop. Dang it.